All right, we are back in Civilization 6 as Abraham Lincoln. That should not come as a surprise because you clicked on this video, but it's a new day for me. I am kind of hopping into this game that I started yesterday, so I got to reacquaint myself. We are going to keep on keeping on here until we own everything Grand Columbia has. We are going to re-suze Mohenjo-Daro so that all of these off-water settles can be good cities again. Then we are going to try and get Imhotep here, which will give us an automatic kind of free Petra up in the Mojave Desert, and that'll be kind of our main plan. Once we have conquered all of this, I think we'll settle down for a minute. We will set up like a proper empire, and then we'll kind of print more units from industrial zones to come over here and maybe mess with Spain. For now, though, we're just going to stick to Grand Columbia and see how we do. It is certainly time, although the commercial hub would be great, it is time for more industrial zones. We need those units. Later in the game, you can get more units from switching between the different power plant buildings, so we don't need to worry that we're using all of our free units on man-at-arms. There will still be options for free line infantries and infantries later, so I'm not worried about that. These units all need to heal, and hopefully we can get to Bogota by the time they build walls. It doesn't look like they're trying to build walls yet, so hopefully we can just sneak in here before they build walls and take their capital. And from there, we might even flip these cities with loyalty, which should be good. And we also need to kind of knock down the amount of envoys he has in Mohenjo-Daro. It's always best in cities that you take over to repair what is already there. This is just because it's the most efficient. So even if I don't really want a holy site right now, there's no point in me doing anything else but repairing the granary and the holy site first. All right, we have earned an envoy, so we will kick him out of Mohenjo-Daro. That does not give us the sous of it, but it has kicked them out, so they will no longer attack us, which is great. I would like to finish this workshop. I had to switch it because they were standing on my industrial zone, but they've been kicked out now, so that is all good. And I think that's great. We're just healing up here, and we're going to head down to Bogota shortly. We've now got the Sioux of Mohenjo-Daro back, but now Candy's attacking us, and that's its own kind of problem. I might have to move Beowulf back up here to get rid of this man-at-arms, but we'll see how we go. I also could entirely just be fine, but we'll see how things go up here. He wants to make peace now. I'm going to say no unless he builds walls in his capital. Niter has been unlocked. Let's see if we have any in the empire. We have one that we can get in Washington, which is perfect. That should be enough. A lot of the Niter units we need we'll just get for free from industrial zones, so I'm actually not too worried about it. Oh no, we have one where our Ruhr Valley was meant to go. Oh dear, that's unfortunate. We can just move the Ruhr Valley here. One second. This should work. This should work. This should be okay. This should be fine. I think we're going to be okay because it's in New Orleans anyway, so that's totally fine. This industrial zone. So in 5 turns, we're going to get 2 more man-at-arms units, which is very, very helpful. If we can go down and actually grab... We're not going to get gunpowder by then, so it'll be 2 more man-at-arms units. It will not be gunpowder. I want to make more use of this builder now that these cities are kind of back online. I'm just struggling a little bit because this man-at-arms is making things a little difficult. And I want to get to these 2 tiles here to chop out this really good campus. I might swing around to this and chop this out here. I'm not really able to move Magnus, so I think we just chop that out. The quicker we can get that science up, the better it is, I think, for us. I'll move you out, and I think I will just purchase a 3rd archer so we can boost those crossbows. And then in 3 turns, I'll upgrade a couple with this. We're about to get really productive builders with feudalism, so that'll be handy. You have incendiaries, which is a really good promotion for what we're doing, so you'll be a great crossbow. And I don't think Bogota is building walls. It doesn't seem like they are. I think we might be able to sneak in there. They might have a unit, but I think we might be okay. We're not actively building walls, so limes can for sure come out. Unit maintenance might be interesting. I'm not really making units. I think even raid might be a really good card here if we're going to do a little bit of pillaging. We can take out Diplomatic League. As many of you pointed out in the comments, I used the card incorrectly. To be fair, I just want to be fair. In almost every situation, I think Charismatic Leader is better, which is why I don't use Diplomatic League very much, which is why I messed it up. So thank you all in the comments for letting me know how it actually works. That was just a little bit embarrassing. I am building a harbor, so veterancy might be good value instead of the 6 gold. I think that's probably good value there. Eventually, industrial zone adjacency will be what we want to go through there. And then serfdom is probably good value here. If we get even just one builder with serfdom, it's immense value. And yeah, we are in a monumentality age, so we can just buy these kind of immense value builders with faith. So we'll just do that. And that's a 5 charge builder. We're going to get this niter. We're going to get this honey and a miner, a couple farms. And we can come down here even. Ooh, we can get a free. We can get a free thingy, a free chariot. Interesting. I didn't even see that was there. All right, Mr. Horse, you're on the case. Thank you, Mr. Horse. Mercenaries is going to be great for all those crossbow upgrades. I'll probably upgrade one. Oh, this is fun. Yeah, everyone needs one unit they can just kind of kill, you know? Just because. No! The Comandante General does do a good job. But what I want to do is I want to kill this next to the vampire for the boost. And then you'll heal one more turn and then we'll head to Pagoda. So pretty much no matter what happens, the archers are going to live. Unless a giant horsey boy like sneaks in. That might be a problem. Oh no, he's gone. He's gone. Okay, that's fine. Diplofavor and iron for gold. We'll take that. No problem. We are going to go indeed to Pagoda. Major defeat. Major defeat, hey? They might build walls really quick, but we're just going to pillage first and hope a volcano hits them. All right, so they're sending in a knight, and this is perfect because we can just eat the knight with Beowulf. Oh, we can because he's a very, very strong knight. Ah, that makes sense. Yeah, the knight's got 62. Can I upgrade to the crossbow? I'll upgrade the one to a crossbow. Are they building walls in Pagoda? They're not building walls in Pagoda quite yet. Things are interesting. Things are interesting. Straight to gunpowder for the free gunman is definitely how we're going to do this. Chosen campus gains 2 housing, 1 amenities. Increases not... It's not the worst, but it's not the best either. That's okay. Chosen campus gains 2 housing and 1 amenities. Increases non-food yield benefits of happiness near empire by 40%. I think we'll grab the amenity in the capital. Yeah, he went and attacked the vampire, which is very silly. Because now he's just going to get murked by the crossbow, hey? Yeah, that wasn't very smart. I don't know if they have, like, unlimited knights to work with. I suspect not, but... I don't think that'll go down as a great choice. No walls, though, and I think they're starting to build walls. Oh, I can't see them. So we do want to start pillaging districts, especially the vampire that heals from the pillages. Now we have that knighter going, too, so that'll be either sellable or usable, depending on how we want to do it. There we go. The 5 turns has hit. We have those free man-at-arms. So they will be heading down the road to where we're going. That's exciting. That's very exciting. I am excited. I don't know exactly what I'm hoping to do district-wise up here, but I think it looks something like this. A couple of aqueducts, a couple of industrial zones, and then wherever else I can kind of manage up here. I do want to try and get some theater squares around too. We might have to bank on taking those from somebody as well to get our culture. So we'll play it by ear. This isn't my favorite, but it is provisional to kind of see how we go up here in Baltimore, New York. And we'll figure out Los Angeles. I suspect a commercial hub is in Los Angeles's future as well. All right, everything is in place. We can see now that they are building walls. And so I don't think we're actually going to take the city. What we want to do here, though, is we want to pillage everything. We want to get as much as we can from all these pillages. And then we want to see if we can lower the combat strength of the city enough. See, that lowered it by 2 to maybe get a few hits into the city and kind of weaken it a little bit. And that way the battering ram can kind of take over once we've done that. Kabul would be super helpful for the... experience if there is a way we can seize Kabul. So we'll head in there and try and do that. We are going to put the unit upgrade card in, 50% discount real quick. That way we can upgrade this archer and this archer to a crossbow on the cheapy cheap. So we're upgrading for 125, which is a very good deal. Crossbows are going to attack here. Yeah, they're not doing a ton, but we are getting some good pillages in, which is important. I don't need this industrial zone exactly yet. I think we get the library first. Although, I do want to plant the industrial zone so that whenever I do get it, it simply just costs a little bit less production. We always want to make sure we are trading our extra goods. We have an extra tea here that I just got. We'll trade that for 11 gold for 30. And our loyalty is good enough in the capital that we can absorb the -2 loss. We are well on our way to having Imhotep. And while I do believe that this might be the best Petra city to ever exist... up in the Mojave Desert, it might be worth actually building the Petra in Cartagena down here. And that way we get all of these tiles kind of really working for us right next to the enemy that we can flip with all the food we're going to get here. We can get a really good city up here. Does that really matter, though, if we can make this city amazing? It's an interesting conundrum to be in, but we are going to have to see once we kind of get this built. Unfortunately for this deer, we are going to have to get rid of it so we can chop out... a aqueduct here. We can also get this university, which will be super helpful for us, so I'm happy about that. We also want to try and be as happy as possible, always looking to purchase luxury resources because of that great scientist we got earlier. I'm going to chop out the aqueduct by removing the university from the queue. What this will do is it will... I gotta remove the resource too. We're gonna chop out the woods first. first, though. That's a lie. We're going to remove the resource first, so my bad. That is another free man-at-arms unit that we can just kind of throw down here. Now, what we do want to test is, I don't know this with Abe, once we get these musketmen unlocked, and what I do wonder if upgrading them begins the process of us having to pay for them or not. Because right now we got these for free and you don't have to use any resources to have them with Abe's ability. But I do wonder if we upgrade them voluntarily, if that means we do end up having to have some kind of trade-off there. We want this university for sure. I'll repair this holy site, that's fine. I think we are going to get Emotep as well. Yeah, we're getting 8 great engineer points per turn. That'll be more now that we have the workshop done, so I think that's perfect. Let's chop out the aqueduct. I'm going to remove the university from the queue, and we're going to chop out the aqueduct here. And the reason why we're going to do that is it'll give me more production, which will speed up the university anyway, so we'll just grab this aqueduct quick. We do almost certainly want this lighthouse, so I'm going to go for that. I'm also going to place down this industrial zone. It is next to 2 kind of strategic resources here, so that's not going to be so bad. And then we'll kind of fill this out. Eventually, I'd love for this to be a couple of theater squares, but we'll see how we go. We have now unlocked monarchy. We certainly want to go into monarchy. We're going to get housing per level of walls. That is the least kind of helpful thing going on here. It's not helpful, but we definitely want more policy cards. We are about to upgrade a bunch of people to musket men. Again, I'm not sure how that's going to work with cost, whether we have to pay maintenance on them or whether we need niter for them. So we are going to find that out, but I am going to need to pay gold regardless to upgrade them. And that's kind of our timing. We're going to get musket men and declare war right away before he can upgrade his units to kind of compensate for that. The play, I think, is going to be straight for Caracas so we can raise that city. And if we can raise Caracas, then we can buy these tiles for a better Petra in Tarkagina or Cartagena. And if we can't do that, then we'll build the Petra up here in this kind of bonkers area. There is Emotep. So the first thing we need to do with Emotep is we actually need to come up here and we need to build the mausoleum at Halicarnassus. The mausoleum at Halicarnassus, let's take a look. Let's take a look at how good this is gonna be for us. 1 science, 1 faith, 1 culture on all coast tiles, whatever. Great engineers have an additional charge. That's what we're here for. We're gonna be earning a lot of great engineers. This has 2 charges, right? And it kind of automatically builds the earlier wonders in the game. So it's gonna automatically build the mausoleum and then it'll give that second charge back. So I'm gonna get a free mausoleum and keep both of these charges. One of them will be for the Petra. One of them might be for Temple of Artemis or something. You can't use them on the Machu Picchu, which is unfortunate, but that's all right. We might even save it and get a little bit less of an effect on a later game wonder. But for now, we are gonna go and build a mausoleum at Halicarnassus in Boston next turn. Perfect. So we have unlocked musketmen now. We can upgrade them for 85 gold. It does require 20 niter. It does require 20 niter. So it does seem like we are going to be slightly limited to the amount of muskets we can upgrade right away here. I just want one to really go and bully Caracas. That's all I really want here. So let's get our unit set up for a bombard of Caracas here. We're going to go straight through the walls with the siege tower. Only having 1 person to trade with is interesting, but he does have niter. So if I can even buy just 8 niter from him this turn with my 3 diplo favor and possibly some iron, yeah, that's perfect. Because now I can upgrade another musket, which is totally worth it. And I think it's a good turn. The problem is, oh no, we don't have a problem. I think we're good to go. I think we can move this. The siege tower is ready. I want to go and hit him while he's undefended. There's only 50 combat strength here. I do wonder what'll happen if we get the siege tower in there and the muskets start attacking. I think we might be able to take him off guard. He moved his knight to Bagoda. And we do have Wukong coming in 3 turns, so we will have some backup. And I do want to get the jump on him, so I'm going to see how this goes. This might end up going terribly, but we're going to try this here. Not you, Spain. I don't want to declare war on you. I do want to declare war on you, though. All right, Simone. We're doing this again. Oh, it's a major victory with the muskets. The problem is the muskets can't attack quite yet this turn. But what I can do is I can hit with the vampire this turn and just pillage next turn. And that might be worth a little something. And the vampire, I think the vampire just doesn't count for the bonus from the siege tower is what's happening here. Oh, they brought their knight out, but not to defend the city. Okay, perfect. This is great. This is great. This is fantastic. All that glisters is not gold. All right, it seems like he's in a golden age because this is bad. He's just in a standard age and we're just in a standard age. So that's fine. That's okay. We'll figure this out here. I guess monumentality is the best one. All right. Well, this is silly because I think I might be able to really do some damage to this knight here. Yeah, I mean, it's not perfect, but it's not nothing either. Then you pillage that for gold and health. Can do some damage to... If I can kill the knight, then the vampire gets a boost, though. And that is worth pursuing. I think I'm just going to defend here. How much damage do the muskets do? A decent chunk. So yeah, this is what we want to go for here. We want to be making sure they're as weak as possible. Can I kill you with my horse? What do we think? Does this horse kill this knight? Because if it does, this vampire gets stronger. It does not. It does not kill that knight. We do get another vampire though. Sanguine Pact. Heck yeah. And with the other vampire, we can get a vampire castle as well. I'm not sure exactly where I want to build that, but up here, there seems to be tons of good spots for it. All right, please die next to the vampire. Please die next to the vampire. Oh, you coward. You coward. You coward. You coward. You coward. You coward. I've been attacked by an aggressive enemy. Don't fund their defense. Do not fund their defense. Okay, they're going to fund the defense. That's unfortunate. All right, huge win coming up. They have retreated their units. Mr. Spain, I am once again asking for your knight or a sit. Never mind. Vampire, you're also bait. Perfect. His next turn, we'll just swap the man at arms with the musket. So that works out totally fine. You are losing loyalty, and that's bad. Wukong's in the house. Okay, Wukong's in the house. You're bait. The knight is just bait. Once Wukong gets here, he's a pillaging machine, so that's fine. We're doing well. We're doing okay. Two more turns till Mausoleum comes in. I think at this point, another builder is warranted. I don't want to keep Caracas. I just want to raise it. Perfect. The bait worked. The bait worked. A lot of things hit that knight. Wukong comes in for a pretty immediately massive dub for us. So let's see if we can do this. You still stay as bait. Wukong attacks. You attack. Can the vampire take it? Possibly? The vampire can take it, yes. Okay, good. Okay, so Caracas is down. There is no world in which we actually keep Caracas. So that's gone. That city's raised. So that should relieve some of the loyalty pressure we're having down here. And then in Cartagena, I want Imhotep to come down because I want him to build the Petra. And we're going to buy these good Petra Desert tiles to make that happen. I just got to wait for Mausoleum to be done next turn. The Petra is worth 400 production, and he'll give it 350. Just build the Petra literally anywhere. I think we lose something here. Probably this man at arms. Yeah, that's okay, though, because it died next to the vampire. And I think your own units count. I think it's just any unit that dies next to a vampire. We'll double check that right now. But we do got the mausoleum, which is great. Enjoy this wonderful building process. Exquisite beauty as no other shade can boast. So now you'll see our engineer is going to have two charges again, which is great. Let's put in... Can I open this? I can open this. Let's put in the wonder card. We're going to put in the wonder building card here instead of conscription. Veterancy can come out at this point. I'll put conscription back in there. We are still upgrading as soon as we can. So what I want... Let's see here. How many units? 6 units that have died near the vampire. So I think it does count your own units. So I would like to kill this vampire or this knight near both my vampires, if at all humanly possible. So I think that achieves the goal. Or not. But I think this vampire can just eat you. That's fine. So both those vampires got boosted. What I want, though, is Wukong to run around and cause a ruckus. So Wukong can live there. Because there, Wukong can't get seen because there's not a unit next to him. Hopefully there's a bonus to it for having the Wonder Card in. There is. So the Wonder Card brought the production down. Then we have enough here. So that Petra's going to go in right away, which should help us gain food right away, which will help us grow right away. So that should be helpful. It's not as good as the Northern Petra, but this one's fine. We like this one. There we go. That's perfect. So let's chop out this marsh. What's our loyalty number at? 58.4, and that's really, really, really not good. And what are you at, Papa Yan? Falling 6.5, that's also really not good. I hadn't put much thought into what the next district tier is. It very well might be a campus, just right next to everything. I think that feels okay. We'll lock it in for now. So next turn, I'm going to be able to get Victor in here, and Victor's going to be very helpful because not only will I get loyalty in this city for having Victor, I'll get loyalty in Papa Yan for having Victor within 9 tiles or whatever it is. So that works totally fine. I just need to get a builder down here real fast to chop out these marshes for population, and I just simply can't afford one with cash right now. And the only person I can trade with is Spain, and he doesn't have a lot of cash to give me. If you live, you didn't live. I was going to say, if you live, then you just get loads of stuff. That's okay, because we need you up here anyway. We need you up here wherever you're going. Where do you go back to? Where is your home? Where'd the vampire go? All right. What can you do in Bogota for me? Let's go to Bogota and see what you can do for me. That's okay. So Wukong is only seen if he's next to a unit. So I think he's good to just pillage here and he can't be seen. There's no unit here either. And then this vampire, I'm just going to send to pillage these tiles. This turn, I can get Victor. So we're going to get Victor in Cartagena. And that's going to give it positive loyalty. And once Victor's in there, it'll give more loyalty to Papillon. I can now put a loyalty card in to help out. So we're not upgrading units yet. Although, I'm not building any more wonders either. So that card comes out. We can at least put Limitene in. Praetorium would also be really good. And I think we move Limitene up instead of the +9 and we put Praetorium in. And that'll severely limit our loyalty issues. So we're gonna smash down a really quick entertainment complex. And then we try and buy the arena for the Colosseum. It's a bit risky, but I think that's gonna be fine. I'm gonna grab an alliance with Spain if possible. Specifically a military one if possible. And then if you can join the war against Gran Colombia. You won't? Are you already at war with him? One sec. No, but you hate him. You hate him. Interesting. Okay, so we'll see how that goes. Yeah, we want garrison commander here. Your cities within 9 tiles get +4 loyalty per turn towards your civilization. So that'll be enough loyalty in Papa Yan to get by. So we're good. Everything is fine. Wukong is just amazing. Like, if there's no units to see him, like, he can just do anything if there's no units to see him. These cities are not gonna last very long at this rate. They are gonna be ours. If we can get through this. Guys, I think our other vampire died. Can vampires die now? Wait, can vampires die now? Where'd our other vampire go? Because that is a bunch of garbage if they can. That wasn't in any patch notes. Oh, this is brilliant. I wish my other vampire didn't die, though. I didn't know that vampires could die. Normally, vampires can't die. I'm gonna go kill his religious unit. We're still gonna get hit because the traitor can see him. But I think it's very funny to condemn the heretic. And I hope he sends his traitor out. And it just kind of slides in next. Okay, let's build this Temple of Artemis. If it's going to be available, we're just going to take it. And then we'll come down here and build this commercial hub. Okay, so Wukong was seen, but that did not cause any issues. And he's got Renaissance walls now. So he's got Renaissance walls here. What that means for us is that we will not be able to do anything on the siege tower front. So we're just here pillaging. The only problem is the vampire is not getting buffed up now. I really did not know vampires couldn't die. All right, now we just need this arena and the Colosseum happens automatically. So 4 turns. Has the Colosseum been built? It is not. Arenas are 600, so I won't be able to buy it. So we will have to wait the four turns, but that's okay. What this marsh is going to do is we're going to chop out this marsh here. It's going to grow the population here, which adds loyalty pressure in this direction. And then eventually with all of the Petra tiles, we also just kind of hype up there as well. Hello, Mr. Wall Guy. The game crashed in between turns, and so I had to replay the last turn. But I think we're in the same spot that we were. We're going to keep pillaging for faith. If we can't do that, I think at this point it's better to pillage for science than culture. And we get out of the way of this traitor. And now we can purchase a hero back. So we can do Beowulf, which is the only hero we've got. That's not Wukong. So let's purchase Beowulf back. And then let's get Beowulf down here to do some damage. I think we'll just chip away at Bagoda. If they're not going to be able to do a ton of damage, I think the problem is they haven't had a crossbow yet, so this walls are still doing archery damage. I'm going to bring the muskets down here, because once I get the crossbows in, we need units for the walls to kind of have to hit, and we need to be defensible. We can't use the siege tower, because they got Renaissance walls. He wants to make peace, but I don't know why we would do that. I think we're in a really good spot. We're probably starving him of his ability. There's the Temple Artemis. We're probably starving him of his ability to buy better ranged units, and he's probably building more cavalry units. I think we're good. It's going to be a slow chip with the crossbows, but I think we'll be fine. And then I think you're really able to set up your full archer complement. It's going to take a while to chip down the walls. But that's okay. We're going to pillage for gold. Pillage for gold again next turn. Gain sources. Listening post. Now, yeah, we want Diplo visibility. That's extra combat strength. Vampires heal with any kind of pillage. So I think... Oh, if we can just eat this guy, that is a free plus one. Yeah. We just got to eat him for the free plus one. Because our good vampire apparently can die. Which I didn't know. That's a major defeat, but it's not nothing. I think you can pillage an aqueduct, though, so we'll get to pillage the aqueduct. I certainly want farms here. I certainly do indeed want farms here. I think that's kind of part of weakening all these defenses. We want the zone of control for sure. Yeah, we'll promote as we go. We're in this for the siege. We know this is going to take a minute. At this point, it might be worth buying a bombard. But those cost 1120, and I do not have 1120. Cool, we're all good there. Can we build the Colosseum? We can build the Colosseum. So we are going to use Emotep for that. Which is perfect. That'll be more amenities. Rome shall stand. When the Colosseum falls, good use of Emotep when you're getting all these great engineers. You want to make sure you're using them. The world shall fall. Wonderful. Look at that. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And I think I want to put Forbidden City is very good. The wildcard policy spot is lovely. I think we try and go for Machu Picchu really quick if we can. Because then this theater square becomes even better. And this industrial zone becomes better. And any commercial hubs by mountains become better. Not that we have too many of those. Doesn't change the fact that they do become better. Oh, that double culture pillage feels so good. Because now we can take this card out here. We can put the builder card right back in. Glorious. Glorious stuff we got happening. I don't think we need this loyalty anymore, to be honest. I think we can change that out. I think we can get conscription. This is just a little bit rough without a bombard, though. I'm not going to lie to you. In any case, free crossbow experience. Look at that. Promotion available. Okay, another promotion here soon. I think we've pillaged everything there is to pillage. I genuinely think the only thing left to do... It's a major defeat, but it's still not even that bad of a defeat. But you can still beat yourself into it pretty good. Three turns until that workshop is done. That'll be another free musket. Now, with that free musket, I just want to make sure we're not going to get lion infantry too quickly, or else I'll hold for that. And we're not. We're still a little bit away from free line infantry, so that's okay. See, now it's only a minor defeat. It is getting better. Because now you can just back out and heal. Is there anything you can pillage? I kind of used all... Oh, you can pillage this for health next turn. You're going to get hit by the walls. You can pillage that for health. Come back. Heck yeah. All right. That works for me. Works for me. This great merchant is going to give us the free trader. Also wonderful. Where do we don't have any roads from up here. We're going to go from Los Angeles down to Mohenjo-Daro to create like a giant road. There we go. Yeah, 7 experience. So yeah, we're just going to level up really quick doing this. This is almost better than having a bombard then if we're just going to get free. Because now we can just heal for a few turns, kick it. You don't heal particularly quickly. Am I at war with Fez? I am at war with Fez, so I can't work these turtles. Big disappointment. That's okay. Minor victory for Wukong. We'll take that. Minor victory for Beowulf. Also takeable. Minor defeat for muskets. Major defeat for muskets still. Okay. Not quite yet. We're almost there. And then same thing here. We're going to come in from Boston to create trade routes as well. Or to create roads. New Orleans! That's my new name for this city. Any great engineers we want? Not particularly. All right, New Orleans. Let's grab. I suppose. We could grab a settler. We are going to want to come and settle this area once we take these two cities. I feel like that's a bit presumptive, though, until we have our bombard that can crack these walls. They're going to build another spy. Let's get the university to start, but what districts do we want? Is an industrial zone feasible here? An industrial zone might be feasible in between the Mercury. Yeah, plus 2 industrial zone right here. Oh, there's an adjacent strategic here. Go for the industrial zone then. We're all about that IZ life. Oh, they got units now. Genetus. All right, now things got interesting. Oh, melee. Please give melee combat strength. Please give melee combat strength. And then we'll go industrial zone, obviously. If we can get industrial zone to build factories, that'd be so good. Encampment is fine. Melee is what we want, though, so that's good. Oh, I can just delete the Gennaro. Well, that worked out. Oh, but now the problem is they have the line infantry, hey? We gotta block the line infantry from the city, though. How much is that bombard? 1120. Okay, I need 80 more gold and everyone hates me. Cool, 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 cool. If I gave you everything and all my children. Yeah, he won't do it for anything. All right, that's gonna take a few turns before we can use the bombard. But we have enough muskets to just kind of throw at the issue. All right, we've shuffled everyone around. We have sufficiently shuffled everyone, so next turn the bombard can get in here and hit some things. Yeah, zone of control for sure. And then you're very close to your next promotion, which will give you 2 hits, which will be worth it. We didn't lose anyone. Everyone is okay. And I think we got the Machu Picchu. Eagles fly. We did get the Machu Picchu. Hell yeah. Good stuff. They eye those walls now crumbling in decay and scarce from quiet rest. All right, good stuff. We love it. We love to see it. Oh, this is not the quickest game of Civ I've ever played, but I'm feeling really good about how I'm playing this one. I wouldn't mind 1 encampment for military engineers later. We are going to need 1 encampment for military engineers. Let's do that right here, Baltimore. Baltimore is getting 1 encampment for military engineers, and that can go right on this road here. All right, the bombard is in place. That's better. And we get a lot of experience on it, so that's good. I can sacrifice Wukong to kill this guy. How much more life? Wukong has 29 turns of life left, though. I can also sacrifice 1 of our 100 musket men, which I will do. Oh, that has a promotion now. Whatever. We're almost at factories, which would be a bunch of free line infantry for us. We just got to unlock them first. Minor defeat. Yeah, hold off. We got a bombard now. We're good. We didn't even lose the musket. I think we might. If we take the city this turn, we can survive. How close are you? 5.7. The 8 turns. I'm going to pass on this one because I can just run projects to get the other ones that I want. I want him to have the bad one. All right, I don't think this will be enough. I do want to kind of make this work, though, because getting the bombard promotions is great. I think we got it. Yeah, we did. We took Bagoda. That's good. Maracaibo is next. And guess what? Maracaibo is already all pillage. So huge win.